Hello, my friends. I'm here again with a QRibots tutorial. There are so many tutorials about QRibots because you can do so much with QRibots. But I'm also making other tutorials, so subscribe on my YouTube channel and give me a thumbs up. That really helps me. Sorry, I'm a little bit ill. I got a little bit cold. But that doesn't influence the tutorials. I hope so. Translating QRibots. There are two ways that you can translate QRibots. Well, there are more than two ways, but I'm going to explain you two ways to translate QRibots. One is to switch from one bot through another bot, and you will do that if you have, for example, videos. So when you are French and you are making a video in French, and you're going to switch to or the clients or the visitors are going to switch to another country, for example, in a country where they speak English, then you can switch to another bot and embed the English version of the video. By default, QRibots translates the bots with the Google Chrome extension. And there is an automatic translator on Google, as you all know. But maybe it's better to do it by yourself. The other way to translate QRibots is to switch from one language to the other language in the same bot. So that is one bot, but the only thing that's you're changing is the language. I'm going to show you first how to switch from one bot to the other bot. As you can see here, I've made a bot that changed from one bot to the other bot. Let's preview it. Okay. It's a simple bot. Ready? Yes. Okay. And then it switched through another bot. So actually, this is another built bot. You must build them. What you can do is when you have built one, then you can copy it and translate the other one. But it's not only for translations. You can do it also, switch another bot. For example, if you want to explain a totally other thing or part of your business, then you can also change from one bot to the other bot. It's very simple. This is the bot. You can see it's just one step. You can do it in one step. So the question is, are you ready? Or do you want to change from one bot to the other bot? And then you simply paste this code in the bot response message. Notice that this has to be from your embed code. Oh, I'm sorry. It must be this code. You see? Don't copy it from the URL because it has also the name bots, and then it won't work. And that's basically all you have to do. It's very simple. The other way is to translate curio bots in the same bots. Let me see. Okay, this is it. Let's preview it. Do you want another language? And this is in Dutch. We further in Engels. If you say yes, then you have to choose which language. So we say English. And this is English. Do you want to go back to Dutch? Well, why not? Okay, and then it's Dutch. Yeah. This is the bot. I started with a question. Yes, no. When the answer is yes, do you want to change language? Then it goes to the second step, language. This is this one. Taal, it's Dutch for language. Choose language, English. Embed this code. Change this if it's another language. And you can find it on the internet. And what you have to do also is making steps, in this case, English and Dutch, and you must do it all over in the bot. In every step, you have to put in an input from the country that people can select from. If you don't do it, then the bot will collapse. And that's all. So thanks again for watching. Sorry that I'm a little bit ill. That's why I'm speaking so badly, but I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and give me a thumbs up, and see you next time, guys.